efforts suffer naught to risen. Now, simply watch as this world's hollow and fruitless order is remade by my hand. The ritual is complete. The dragon comes. Behold! The Royce Dragon. By my power, the dogma of dragons is unmade. Stand arisen. We must all be freed from the vulgar order wherein the dragon's existence determines all.
Hast thou summoned the resolution to face me? Then answer me this. Why dost thou fight? Is it to reclaim thy flesh, thy stolen heart? Or is it to reclaim thy throne? I offer thee a choice. Grant unto me this life in my claws, and be gone from this place. Or stand and fight. Pitiable arisen. The time for thou to make thy choice is come. Show me the path thou wouldst walk. Go, and thou shalt live to claim thy coveted throne. Fight, and thy life is forfeit. Charges. I as the dragon, and thou as the arisen. Climb upon me. We shall depart for our true battlefield.
Become a fleeting, fragile, vacuous thing.
nothing. Bereft of the cycle, naught would be born into it save chaos, great and terrible. Surviving in such a world would be no simple matter.
Was it Sumerism? You have fulfilled your charge, are you not satisfied? Seek you greater status? Perhaps to rule the world entire? It is power you desire, you need merely spy out the path.
The choice is thine, Arisen. By thy will alone can the course of the winners of fate be altered.
You would still resist your fate. Understand you the folly of such a decision. Even the beating of your reclaimed heart was born of the great will of this world. Yet you would abandon it. Everything in this world, all that you have come to know as reality, is the creation of the Great Will. Should that will be lost, no mortal being can survive. However, if regret yet assails your spirit, then perhaps you should reaffirm your choice. Witness with your own eyes, or through the eyes of another, the fate of this world.
It is thy will to defend the world, then thou needst simply bring me low. Yet what reason hast thou to attempt such a feat?
Turn back.
Leave now, while you can.
You have strayed, Arisen. And for what? Lest you forget. You have a world where you belong. There, you are to fell the great evil in your path and rule the people as their sovereign. For that is who you are. And it is my wish that you should live out that life of purpose. The time has come for you to return. Go. My children shall see you there safely.
Let us go home. Together.
To a world under your rightful rule.
To a world all your own.
This is your will? Then behold, a world unmerciful, bereft of the benevolent hands of God. This is your world, the world to which you longed to return. Alas, if only you had chosen to become sovereign. At the end of your travails, you could have ruled over these lands in perpetual peace. Yet that world of limitless possibilities has ended. You stand now upon its remains, the vestiges of a world that could have been so much more. Innumerable wills have served to deliver this world from extinction time and time again. You alone have refused to carry out that great purpose. What you see before you is the consequence of your apathy. Behold. As it has failed to be chosen, and as 'twill ne'er be read, this world will soon cease to exist. In the blink of an eye, the sickle of oblivion will reap aught that you have known. I would advise you not to waste these last moments. Explore the remnants of this world while you can. Perhaps, in doing so, you shall come to see the truth. And know the wretchedness of a world unworthy of being chronicled. How shall you fare, I wonder? Will you endure in this world, abandoned and unprotected?
Master!
Thank you.
oblivion fades. This tale's end has been unwritten. My heart, it aches. A new world comes. A new tale is set to unfold. Yet, it seems I will not be there to watch it.
Greatness with no